kid sat down next to me and said, "Convert me," because that's the kind of kid he is. And I realized something, because I've had doubts, I'm sure we all have, and I realized that you really believe in something when you have to defend it to somebody else. And I realized that a lot of what I thought about God seems like, hopefully, the way it is, and I think I was able to convince myself as much as I was able to convince him. And what that is I believe in Jesus, but I don't think there really is my Jesus or your Jesus. I think there is just one, and there's many different understandings of him, all of them imperfect, mine probably more perfect than most, and that we basically all have to try to figure out from what he said and what the Bible says who he is. And what I've gotten from that is the biggest thing I've realized about God is he is a God of the head and a God of the heart. That he does not expect us to check our brains at the door. In fact, that is the last thing he ever wants us to do. He actually wants us to use them more than we would without him. Because I've realized that God is not just something that we hear in Sunday school. It is really something full of philosophy, full of logic, full of history and reasoning, and that's something that I think has really helped me. But he's also a God of the heart. Basically, religion, I don't think, is a bunch of rules. Like Donald Miller said, it's more like getting married than practicing voodoo. And what I think about that is that definitely it is a mystery in a lot of ways. God is something that in some ways we just have to admit that we can never know and have to take it on faith. That he is something our minds can't understand, and I think that is why people in the literature has always talked about the sacred mystery, because that's really what it is, because we're only human. And I think that the church is here, basically, like Wes said, to be Jesus on earth, which is a lot harder than it sounds. I can remember reading the Gospels and thinking that a lot of what Jesus does is a lot of the opposite of what a lot of people see the church is doing. And that he has called us to love the sinners. I mean, the criminals, the tax collectors back then, figure out who they are in the world we have today, I guess. And definitely to be open to people. And one thing that I really realized about God is that a lot of people think that he's a sort of a comfort in the way things are now, that he's going to look down nicely on what they're doing and make them feel good. And that's a quote from my other favorite Christian writer, who's quoted by the other writer, C.S. Lewis, who said that people expect that, they don't realize that what God is offering them is either a master or a judge. And I think that's really interesting, that God has called us not to be comforted in just going on the way we are, but to change us into something much better, to give us comfort beyond what we can ever have in this world. Because I believe that God really is the fulfillment of everything we want, because he made us for him, so what else can he be for us? And, to quote yet another wise man, that's about all I have to say about that.